Hello and welcome to this talking tour on Australia's premier wine, food and tourist region, the famous Barossa Valley in South Australia. Over the next hour or so on this CD, we'll provide you with a deep understanding of this remarkable valley, how it came to be Australia's principal wine region, how its foods and dining experiences are adding new and diverse layers of richness to visitors' experiences, and how its people and their stories make the Barossa such a striking part of Australia. Like wine regions in Europe and other parts of the world, there's a deep history here, a provenance like no other. This is no pop-up, no newbie wine region developed over recent years on the back of investment dollars. No, this is a region built by pioneers and their families who saw the area's potential and whose hard work and stories will linger and enrich your mental palate as much as its wine and food will enrich your other senses. Tuesday, January 23, 1839. The Gulf of St. Vincent. Two miles offshore, the bark Katharina is beating its last weary leg to Adelaide and the new colony of South Australia. The morning watch ends as fresh southeasterly breezes push the Katharina to its final destination. It's a crisp 58 degrees Fahrenheit and slightly cloudy. Compared with where the Katharina had been and the storms it had experienced since leaving Hamburg, bound for the bottom of the world around the Cape of Good Hope 4 months previously, this moderate swell and the cool weather is literally a breath of fresh air to the 121 German emigrants on board. Amongst those on board were 33-year-old Christian Ulricht, his 30-year-old wife Marie Elizabeth, and their two sons, then 6 and 4. Like their fellow passengers, their smiles all round but stunned silence as they look at the shores of their new home. No established port here, nothing like the ports of Europe, just a muddy, mosquito-ridden swamp, aptly named Port Misery, where they're about to step on land, but through a stinking bog. Is this what they expected? It was this group which ultimately made its way to the Barossa Valley, settling in Bethany and Langmuir, and in areas now known as Tanunda, Siegersdorf, and Nuriutpa. Christian Ulricht was a blacksmith and as such was an invaluable member of his community. As his family grew and as his influence grew, Christian Ulricht purchased parcels of land in the Barossa, eventually giving up his blacksmith business to become a farmer. Along the way, Christian Ulricht planted vines on his properties, as did his fellow settlers, giving birth to the industry which makes the Barossa so famous today. Wine made from Christian's very first plantings can still be tasted at the Langmuir Winery in Tanunda, where today, some century and a half later, his original plantings are noted to be some of the oldest and rarest vines of their type in the world.